Good evening to everyone. My paper presentation is case report of unusual locations of pancreatic pseudocyst. My name is B.M.P. Krishna Reddy from Krishna Institute of Medical Sciences. A 35 years male presented with mild epigastric pain came for CCT abdomen with history of acute abdomen 15 days back, and there is no any history of admission, and he was treated locally. There is known case of alcoholic. The laboratory parameter shows normal hemoglobin and elevated serum amylase and serum lipase levels. And the clinical diagnosis was acute pancreatitis. And in our department, the triple phase CECT abdomen and pelvis was done. Cross-sectional imaging on the delayed post-contrast studies, we can appreciate the peripherally enhancing hypodense lesion in the tail and body of the pancreas, communicating with the main pancreatic duct. And the below section cross-sectional showing the peripheral enhancing lesions in the tail region, which are communicating with the singular lesions, which are noted in the gastrohepatic area along the lesser curvature. And coming to the sections of the liver, here we can see some hypodense lesion in the uncinate process is communicating with the bilobed lesion in the caudate of the liver. And down is the cross-sectional section in the venous phase, showing the abrupt cutoff of the splenic vein, which is suggestive of thrombosis. On the cross-sectional, on the coronal section, delayed images and axial images, we can appreciate the multiple hypodense cystic lesions, which were seen along the lesser sac, where superior extending into the posterior mediastinum, which were almost adjacent to the left atrium. Coming on the post-contrast CT imaging, the pancreas appears to be atrophic with the prominent main pancreatic duct. The multiple localized peripherally enhancing hypodense lesions are noted predominantly in the tail and body of the pancreas. The few of them are communicating with the main pancreatic duct. This also been communicating with the smaller cyst along the lesser sac, extending superiorly into the posterior mediastinum, posterior to the left atrium. One of the hypodense lesion in the uncinate process is seen communicating with the bilobulated lesion in the caudate lobe of the liver. The splenic vein shows abrupt cutoff in the distal aspect with multiple collaterals in the presplenic region. Pancreatic pseudocyst are a complication of the pancreatitis defined as a collection of pancreatic juice enclosed by a wall of non-epithelialized granulation tissue or fibrotic capsule. The pancreatic pseudocyst formation is a common complication of pancreatitis. Commonly, it is seen in the pancreatic and peripancreatic areas. The most of the pseudocysts are located around the pancreatic gland, but they also have been described at a greater distance from the pancreas and the mediastinum to scrotum when the fluid dissects through the tissue planes. The mediastinal pancreatic pseudocyst is a rare complication of pancreatitis. The splenic parenchymal involvement also been defined in the literature. Very rare location for a pseudocyst during acute pancreatitis is in the liver, with only few cases being previously described. The pancreatic pseudocyst in the lumbar triangle, psoas muscle, and intercostal space and obturator externus also been described in the literature. Pseudocyst may be asymptomatic or may present with variety of symptoms like abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, upper GIT bleeding. The diagnosis of complications of pseudocyst like infection, hemorrhage, and cyst rupture can be diagnosed at earliest possible stage and reduce the morbidity of the patient. Coming to the conclusion, unusual locations of pancreatic pseudocyst are very rare. On CT, the imaging, the extent of lesions and complications can be well established. One of the differentials of the mass in the posterior mediastinum should be kept as a pancreatic pseudocyst in appropriate clinical settings. The management of the patient depends on unusual location of the pseudocyst and the complications caused by it. The most of the cases can be managed conservatively. However, surgical interventions such as splenectomy, distal pancreatectomy, and percutaneous drainage are also indicated in severe cases. These are my references. Thank you.